a very different kind of scary. You know, for years I've been working that muscle as a writer, revealing. Writing is about revelation. It's about opening. It's about telling the truth. And I've taken a lot of risks and done a lot of scary things as a writer. But I'm in control of it. Those are my words. I decide what stays in and what comes out. And when I said yes to Reese and Bruna, and then I said yes to Nick, and then I said yes to Jean-Marc, and I had to trust all of these people and more to both tell my story, honor my story, be true to it while also making it their own. And so, yeah, I was a bit terrified. And it didn't really hit me until right before I saw the film for the first time last spring. And I think I was nervous in a way that I have never been before. When I sat down to watch, I was sitting with Bruna and Reese and Jean-Marc and my husband, and I just thought, I mean, here I had to let go. I had to release the truth of my story into other artists' hands. And so, yeah, it was terrifying. And it turned out really well. I'm so proud of the film and the work that these people did. Just about everyone in the book has come out of the woodwork and found me again. I looked for people when I was writing the book, but those I couldn't. They've come out. But the one person I haven't found is Jimmy Carter of the Hobo Times.
You're out there.
I researched. You must remember this was 1995.
He's the editor of Vogue.
This was 1995, before the internet and such. So, but when I was writing the book, I went and searched for the Hobo Times online. Couldn't find them, and the hobos aren't very good at archiving, you know, materials and such. But I never have found him. But it was one of those experiences that I always want to stand up in the film and say, "This really actually happened, just as you see," because it seems so bizarre. And those details of like what was in the hobo care package, I wrote them down in my journal. You know, as I was drinking that beer, it really did happen that way. So I loved it that it made it into the script and the film as well. So the film had actually started production, and Bruna and Jean-Marc had met my daughter Bobby and said she looks like Reese, you know, young Reese, and would she like to play the role? And so I talked to her about it.
Would she like to audition?
Would she like to audition? Uh-huh. And that was, they were like, we're not going to just hand this to her. So I talked to her, and I said, you'll have to be in some unhappy scenes. She knows that I didn't have a good father, and you'll be in some happy scenes with the woman who plays your mother. And she just said no right away. So we just left it. But some time went by. They couldn't find a young Cheryl, and she overheard me talking to my husband about it. And she just said from the backseat of the car, I want to audition. So then we tried to talk her out of it because we wanted her to really want this. And we went for the audition, and she sent me and my husband out of the room. She was alone with Jean-Marc and the casting director, and she auditioned and got the role. And she was such a hard worker and so fantastic. I've never been more proud of her. And, of course, it was really emotional for me to watch my daughter be, you know, present with this man playing my father, who's saying terrible things, who's doing terrible things to her and her mother and her brother. And then, on the contrary, to have her dancing with Laura and leaping into Laura's arms. I really, it was like watching my life flash before me. And, if writing heals some wounds, in so many ways, witnessing the making of this movie healed those too. And never more powerfully than when I was watching my daughter live my childhood. She wants to be an actress now. but if you asked her, every time I say, now get ready, because somebody might ask you, like, well, why do you want to be an actor? And she says, donuts, craft services. and I'm like, I think you have to have something more than that. Did you go into it for donuts?
No.
I've been a feminist all my life. I learned the word when I was like 5 or 6. And I do think it's kind of interesting to me that, you know, suddenly we're hearing so much more about feminism and I guess mainstream culture. And I think it's finally that there are so many powerful women, so many intelligent women, so many ambitious women who are just very tired of being on the sidelines. And so, you know, I didn't plan for this book to be this sort of like iconic, you know, story of a feminist. It was simply me writing my story. And I think that we didn't plan this as a film, but you hear Bruna and Reese talk about the reasons they founded their company. And, you know, it was all about, we're just not going to sit quietly anymore. And, you know, the work that women who came before us have done was, you know, got us so far, but it didn't get us all the way. And so now we're just stepping forth, I think, and people are noticing it. I'm writing about it within that context. But I think it's born out of just a very natural desire to take ourselves seriously and be seen as such. I really wasn't afraid on my hike. I wasn't afraid of most of the men I met. I think it's not a surprise to most women that we are strong and that we can, you know, do things that other people tell us that we shouldn't or can't do. Mm. I wouldn't say it was difficult. It was painful for me to contemplate my mother's death being reenacted. And it was striking that Jean-Marc chose to do it so accurately. What I wrote in the book about how my mother dies and how I found out she was dead and all of those details are seared into my memory, into my mind, and I wrote about them very honestly in the book. And then Jean-Marc and Reese and the actors and Laura recreated that. And so I always cry at that scene. It was really important to me that Laura understand who my mother was, that she wasn't, she was this incredibly, gloriously good mother. I think we seldom get to see that, right? When do you get to see a good mom who's not idealized, who's imperfect, who's human? And I wanted Laura to know that about my mom. She and I spent quite a lot of time talking about both of our mothers and ourselves as mothers, and she brought all of that into the role. So it wasn't hard. I would say that the word I feel is just so lucky. I think that she and my mother share this enormous optimism. You know, a reporter recently called Laura Dern sunshine in human form. And I think that that's very accurate. My mother was that too. When I was a teenager, that annoyed the shit out of me. But now I think it's one of the greatest gifts of my life.